Boxing in Peso Mosca. Here we go, three rounds, flyweight action.
Debutar en artes marciales mixtas fue algo inexplicable, una sensación que nunca imaginé. Me sentí libre, completamente libre.
Guillotine.
Austin there. It's in. He's out.
Nice.
Stopped it. Doc Turnage ending it. And sexy Dulce staking her claim, leaving down.
Dulce Garcia, Melissa Martinez, Amanda Serrano, Melissa Cervantes, Yasmine Jaurequi, Desiree Yanez. What do all of these powerful women have in common? They are changing what it means to fight like a girl. But is the world of combat sports finally ready to listen?
La gente sabe que las mujeres damos mejor pelea. Somos tan aguerridas. Casi siempre nos vamos a los tres rounds.
We're trying to put on a performance of being a strong, independent woman that we can rule this sport like all the men do.
For decades, female professional athletes have suffered unequal pay, lacking representation in sports coverage, and even berating ridicule from sports critics and journalists alike. Since Ronda Rousey made her first professional appearance in the revolutionary UFC 157, female MMA fighters have been stepping up to shatter the glass ceiling of the male-dominated sport, battling the naysayers, the body shamers, and the constant parade of people over-sexualizing female bodies. These professional athletes work day in and day out to sharpen their skills. With most female fighters training an average of 25 hours a week leading up to a fight, these ladies work hard for months to prove themselves worthy of a place in La Jaula.
The training is grueling, it's intense, the adrenaline, it's an amazing feeling.
The struggles in MMA are echoes throughout other women's sports.
Yeah, I feel like I have not gotten the respect I deserve from being a five-division world champion, six-time five-division world champion. And yes, beating Miguel Cotto's record, I thought that I would get a little more recognition and respect, but it's still the same. If I was a man and if I had half of what I have now, I would be rich.
A majority of professional sports fans could probably affirm their knowledge of professional women's leagues, but fail to submit the names of any teams associated with those leagues or even top players. Additionally, professional female athletes are compensated significantly less, despite over 80% of sports fans having an interest in some women's pro sport. Combate Americas decided to turn the tables with Combate Reinas, an MMA competition featuring women's bouts in the top four card slots.
Combate Americas está apoyando a las mujeres. Hay mucha historia detrás de cada una de estas atletas.
Creo que está sorprendiéndolos a Supermeli, mira.
¡Oh! ¡De rodillas, señores! ¡Ahora mortal de la Supermeli! ¡Puede terminar esto! ¡Ya ahí está, señores! ¡Por la vía del knockout!
The event was a major success in rating and fan engagement, but can this type of event work on a regular basis? And what does it take for a female professional fighter to make a name for herself?
It just motivates me in life as well, because I am a girl trying to be in a man's world, and it just, you know, just even training with the guys, I push myself to hang in the same level with them so they can know that, you know, I'm here and I'm not going anywhere, and I'm gonna try to continue to break barriers.
Para mí el apoyo de mi familia es sumamente importante. Ellos son los que me han impulsado desde niña.
Siempre he sido como muy competitiva, sea en el deporte y sea en cuestiones académicas. Entonces siento que eso de competir todo el tiempo nos ha llevado a crecer.
Es complicado insertarse en un gimnasio y comenzar a entrenar artes marciales. Por lo general piensan que no lo podemos lograr o que nos vamos a cansar, la diferencia de un poquito del peso. También eso son fortalezas. Yo creo que las mujeres que hacemos artes marciales somos incluso más fuertes de que muchos varones.
Nada que ver con que esto es de hombres.